Oh, Father, what a joy it is tonight to gather as we celebrate the marriage of Elise and Matthew. And Father, I am so blessed when I see a young couple come together with you at the center of their marriage. I pray for your blessing upon it. And Father, tonight I am reminded of Matthew 6:33, which says something like, give first priority to Jesus Christ and the value of his kingdom, and everything else will turn out just right. And Father, in other words too, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. So Father, I pray for your blessing upon them, and may you be the center of their lives today and always. And Father, may they always remember to give particular emphasis on you and their family, Father, the two most important things in their marriage. So Father, bless them, bless this time. Thank you for the fellowship and the conversation and the fun that will be following, and we ask for your blessing upon this group. And it's your precious name we pray this evening. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Whatever. I'm a teacher. I have a big voice.
We would like to welcome you to Elise and Matt's wedding reception. And before we get things started, there are two things we're going to take care of first. And the first thing we're going to take care of is a little something that maybe needs to happen at the wedding ceremony, and that's the unity candle. And thanks to, Matt's uncle, we get to light it. So please look up here as they light their unity candle together.
Safety first.
Yay!
The second thing we'd like to take care of is cake. So if all of the cousins that are
it's a speed artist.
I know, but at least let's do cake now.
Oh, we're doing cake.
People actually already, sorry about this, but y'all were just so excited for the cake, you went and got it.
Yeah.
It wasn't actually supposed to happen. We should have told you. It's okay, totally fine. So if all of, if you are of a cousin.
No, we have the cutting.
Yep.
Oh. We are flexible.
Okay.
So we're going to cut the cake.
Okay. We're going to cut the cake.
We're going to cut the cake.
All
Now be nice to each other.
Good job. Now that the cake has been cut, it's time for everybody to have a piece. So if all of the cousins that belong to Matt or to Elise, if you would all rise and head over to the cake station. You are in charge of passing out cake to everyone. And I promise it's the last job you have. So head on over there.
It was him. He started it all.
It is a lot of cousins.
Mark, look at all the cousins. Look how many cousins. All cousins.
So when they do census around here, they just come to your house.
Oh,
I mean, the bride has found Mr. Wright. The groom has found Mrs. Wright.
It is. But did you tell him that her real name is really Always? Always Wright. It's true.
Always.
Yeah,
we're really happy to be here today. Yeah, oh, tonight's full of those kind of jokes. Yep. Yeah.
So tonight we're going to have a little bit of a program. Our family has a tradition of doing some singing and performing at people's weddings, and so we find it's only fitting that Elise gets a little program of hers too. So the great thing about tonight is that it's not just going to be Eric and I, but it's also going to be Matt's family, other people in our family, and our friends too. So we're really excited.
I'm looking forward to a good part.
Yes.
There are some announcements we need to make first about what's on your table, and that would be the WebKits challenge. So hopefully you have the app already installed on your iPhone or your Android, and then throughout the program, we're going to be asking you to participate by taking certain shots, and then they're supposed to be
projected
onto the screen over there. Right?
Yep, that's right. So that's how you can participate tonight. And if you don't have a phone,
who's got
that's okay.
Cool.
Yes.
Who's got
any? Wi-Fi. On the
oh, free.
And you can share.
And you can share.
Yep.
So.
And we also have a popcorn and candy bar out there. And I think the candy is pretty much gone, but there might be some. And I think there's a little bit more. It's pretty hot today. So if you need more, there's stuff in the back. Otherwise, just sit back and enjoy. The first thing we're going to start with is, his name is Dan Meyer. He is Matt's uncle, and he is an artist. Right over there. So you give him a round of applause. Dan is a fantastic artist, and he sometimes is in the Valley of the Arts as well, where he does scene artistry. So you give him about 30 minutes, and open poster board, and marker, and his own ideas, no notes, and he just makes art on the fly in a certain amount of time. And he's also doing this session of bringing those to football. So I thought this was the coolest thing. I've never met anybody who can do that. I wouldn't, but looking forward to what you can do. You have an opportunity to speak out of the artist's net, and Dan, you have as much time as you would like to create a piece of art for the bride and groom. So your time is coming in now. You
got it. Right, Dan.
The drawings tonight, our first performers are ages 4 and 2 and 86. So they are Nick Nettlestead. Yep, going up. Nick Nettlestead, Kirsten Nettlestead, and Grandma Darlene. So Grandma Darlene is the bride's grandma. And these two here, Nick and Kirsten, are nephew and Elise, or nephew and niece of Elise.
Yay! Woo!
So as Grandma comes up, Grandma Darlene has a very unique skill that she can play the piano totally by ear. So Grandma Darlene doesn't use any music. She just knows the song. And she knows the key songs are in. And whatever's in her mind just comes out of the key. And the story goes that she kind of developed that skill because as she was younger, she didn't want any dishes. So she's got other dishes and got good piano.
This is something that her whole family could do. So I have aunts and uncles and Christensen's, and my aunts and uncles could play, one play the ukulele, they could play guitar, and all by ear. Yeah, I can't. Now, kids are going to try to sing, and they were the
They were the ring bearer and the flower girl, and Kirsten hasn't had a nap, so this is how it goes. She's kind of her mother's daughter. We'll really see how it goes.
She's so cute.
She's so cute.
Thank you. Wade almost burned down the cornfield and died.
Oh. Very accurate.
Yes, we were lighting up a lantern thing that we would do it for the divide, and it was supposed to go up in the sky, and it did not. So we ended up chasing it through 3 feet of snow. It was quite memorable. Keep it from, you know, keep Minnesota countryside safe.
When Lisa and I were in middle school, we went to middle school dances, and there was one very memorable middle school dance where, if you can remember middle school dances when you were kids, there was a lot of maybe dirty dancing there, and there was a lady, she was a middle schooler, of course. But we were reminiscing on how she wound him into a fine powder with a quote that Ali said afterwards. It was one of my favorite quotes.
All right, Wade, tell me, who has the best memory?
Yes.
is a mantis shrimp. If you're not familiar with them, they are rainbow beasts that are tiny, but they are the most powerful animal per ounce in the animal kingdom. So I think that's pretty awesome. Matt is a falcon, also is a millennium falcon, but mostly because he's intelligent and cunning and stealthy. Mine's a little sad. My reason is that as long as I know Elise, she is always through droughts, whether it be a fake drought, whether it be losing her strength, she is always smart enough to get herself through and to help others. So that's why you are a champion.
Right.
And a shrimp.
And a shrimp.
Okay, it's up to you. This is the final vote. Who will give? It's Anna.
Yes.
But only Anna do you have her face.
So when did we meet? 3 years ago? 2 years ago?
Okay, well, I will let Anna give a speech. But all jokes and fun aside, Anna and I really love each other. We are very, very, very best friends. Anyways, if you were at my sister's wedding, you know I'm not good at impromptu speeches, so I wrote something down, and I won't embarrass myself on that yet. So, I'm going to keep mine short, sweet, and to the point. Elise and Matt, I love you both, and I wish you all the hope and happiness and magic, I'm not going to cry, in the world. So I want us all to raise our glasses to Elise and to Matthew. Here's your 50 plus years of happy marriage. Cheers.
Cheers.
And now, the
maid of honor will give her speech. Or the winner. One of my favorite things about Elise is kind of a weird one. It's what she is in what psychologists call a dual converser. That's not real, I made it up. But what that means is when you start a conversation with someone, usually it quickly shifts to someone's side of the conversation. So you end up talking about whoever has the most interesting life or whoever has the bigger thing going on. And Elise doesn't let that happen, and that's just such a rare thing. She, even if I'm talking about steamed broccoli, and she's talking about, I don't know, planning a wedding, getting married to the man of her dreams, moving 500 miles away, she still doesn't let my side be forgotten because she values who you are as a person, and she genuinely is interested in what you have to say, even if you're talking about steamed broccoli. So that's a wonderful quality, which I'm sure Matt knows and appreciates. One of the things I appreciate the most about as a couple is I went down with them to Colorado when they went to look at their home for the first time. Before they even knew they were going to be living there, they went there for the first time, and I went along with them. I was the only one who went along with them on their cute little couple trip. So that could have been real awkward real fast. However, it wasn't for a moment. I never once feel like third wheel because both of them are such kind, caring, and genuine people, and they genuinely look out for other people. Even though they are so in love with each other, you can just see that they could be completely wrapped up in each other if they let themselves. But they don't. Because they really care about those around them and want them to be comfortable and have a good time. And that's just one of the most amazing qualities that you can ask for in a couple. Not that I need to be included or, you know, be made feel special, but just that they could be so self-centered between each other, but they don't let that because they value, they love, and it's just amazing. So congrats to both of you. I love you dearly, both. Toast to that couple.
That was great. Now we'd like to hear from the best man, who is Nick's brother. I'm sorry, who is Matt's brother, Nick.
Be good, Nick.
I've been having trouble writing the speech. Obviously, I was at my grandpa and grandma Matheson's about a week ago and told Grandpa that I still hadn't written the speech. Is that better?
Yeah.
All right. It's great being able to hear myself talk. But I was saying that I was having trouble writing the speech, and he told me that I didn't need to write anything down, just get up here, say a few nice things, and tell you that I bet you can make 10 years. Probably keep on with that, but I'm trying to think of some embarrassing stories to tell about you. And most of them are too self-incriminating to actually tell people. One of the earliest memories that I had is when you decided to gather all the neighborhood kids around. Outside of our window, outside of our house, we had a glass door. That Matthew, for some reason, when he was running out one day, he didn't press the door handle to push it open. He thought that he learned a new magic trick that he could show everybody. So he gathered us around the door, and we were just watching, didn't know what he was going to do, and he just starts poking it towards the door, and just crashes through the window. And I wasn't sure if that was a good story to tell, because that is a story where you decided to bring everybody together and show that you were overly confident about something and embarrass yourself. Really, what kept coming to mind when I was going to write your best man speech, or I wrote it right here, when I was writing your best man speech, was just when we moved from the big house to the house that Mom and Dad live on now. I know saying big house sounds like we'd have a nickel together in jail, but when we first moved there, I didn't realize that it was going to happen so quick. I thought we were just staying there for a night and then going to go back to the old house for a little while. And I just remember playing beanie babies with you and just having you there. And it made it a lot easier to transition from one stage of life to the next, and there were a lot of changes. And seeing you get married here, you're going up to Colorado, and both of you are going to have that experience where you get to grow with each other. And you're starting a new transition in life, and I know that you are a person that just shows a lot to everybody, and both of you are, really. I've always felt comfortable with you. You always are trying to better me, which can be when you've always been yourself. And one last thing I do want to say is that you need to remember, Matthew, that Elise is a princess. And once a princess, always a princess. And also, Matthew, you are a knight. And as a knight, you are called to protect, honor, and strengthen Elise. And I know that you are going to do great together. I just want to say to us that I know that you bring each other so much happiness. I love you both. Happy to be able to call you my sister and
keep
my
brother. All right.
Woo-hoo! Cheers.
What
do you want to do? Got me
scared. Before we go on to our next performance, it's time for the WebPix channel. So take out your phone. And this time, you have 45 seconds to take a photo with you and someone you don't know, either at your table or nearby. So get your selfies.
I messed up this here.
You did.
I don't have my coin. Now what am I going to do? Is it better? No?
I got a coin. Is Jerry Peterson going to accompany you? Can you sing? Jerry Peterson will accompany you.
No
I'm sorry.
No
she was the pianist organist during the ceremony today, and she's going to be accompanying
her.
She's also
taught
our singer, and the music was going to a concert. So thank you very much.
Yeah, don't open it. Oh, that's okay.
It's like, well.
She's such a good helper.
She is.
So I told Lena, I said, Lena,
I want you to go get a new ball. You know.
Can leave?
She can do that. She can do that. She can do that. So I leave her all the money that I have.
All
of it, which is $301.
Oh my, you think she can get a ball?
She can do it. So you know, she went out and she found a beautiful ball. Yeah, the ball is very expensive, $300. So you know, she has $1 left over, and she still has to, you know, get a hold of me so I can come and get her and the ball.
Did she come?
Well, you know, first she goes to the telephone, but it's $2. It's way too expensive.
That's work.
She only has $1, you know. So then she goes to the telegraph office, and they say, you know, Lena, it's $1 per word in the telegram.
Oh.
So my Luna, she sends me a telegram. She says, she sends the verb comfortable.
Comfortable? That doesn't even make sense.
Now you know my Luna Yuli. She's so smart.
Well,
come for Kabul. Kind of a story.
She is one crafty girl.
Yeah.
Well, you know, I was wondering. I haven't seen Lars for a long time. How's he?
Lars is pretty good. Lars
is
pretty good. Good news on Lars' account. Yeah, he's got a new baby boy.
Oh, yay.
New baby boy. You know, actually, I want to go see this new baby boy, me and Lena. So Lena, she said before we go, now hold it. When you see the new baby, don't say anything about that baby's ears.
His ears?
Because he doesn't have any. So, I didn't say anything. I go over to Lars, I said, Lars, what a beautiful baby. You know, look at those arms. You know, he's got very strong arms. I said, oh yeah, you know, he's going to be a boxer, very strong. He said, yeah. And he said, you know, Lars, he's got very strong legs. Oh yeah, he's going to be a dragster, you know, very strong legs. And then I said, you know, Lars, look at those beautiful baby blue eyes. And Lars said, well, you know, I've got such good vision. The boy's going to have 20/20 vision. And I said to Lars, well, I sure hope so, because he won't be able to wear any glasses.
Well, you know that Lena, she is a good girl. She had great advice when she told you to keep quiet about that. How many years have you guys been married?
Me and Lena, we've been married now 25 years.
25 years.
Thank you.
Now, do something special for your 25th anniversary?
And of course, Julie.
Oh,
you know, we went to my homeland, which is Norway.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
You were quite the spender there. But now I'm going to ask you this. On your 50th anniversary, what are you going to do then?
I'm going to go get her then.
Well, Ollie, you are quite the character. It's so fun to visit with you. But, you know, I was just wondering, you know, Ollie and Matt are just getting married this evening.
Yeah, sure.
And we have a beautiful wedding for them. But here's the clincher. Elise is going to have to start cooking now.
Oh, yeah. Well, Maggie, she cooks for me.
Is she
good? Oh, my name is very good cook.
Oh, good. Now, what is your favorite thing to eat?
My favorite food? You know, it has to be Norwegian donuts. Norwegian donuts. Yeah, sure.
Well, what's in your bag then?
Well, I have a gift. I have a gift.
Yeah.
I come with a gift. And you know, since cooking can sometimes be hard and take a lot of time.
You have beautiful packaging there.
That was the best. I have here Norwegian donut seeds. When you run out of time, you just take them, put them in a ground, and Norwegian donuts.
Been a pleasure to spend the evening.
No, thank you. You too.
And you know, I'm just wondering. I haven't seen Lena and all these people. Is she here? And I missed her.
Yeah, Lena is here.
She is. I would love to see her. Would you bring her out to see?
Well, Lena's out in the pickup.
What?
Hell yeah. She's waiting for me out in the pickup.
Well, you came to the wedding.
I can't believe we're still married, 25.
I can't believe it. Well,
I better be going.
I think you better, or before Lena.
Vivanta Deshu Mianina, many happy years of marriage. As good as Mianina has had.
25 and going.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Daryl.
Oh, I'm sorry, Daryl.
Daryl.
My apologies. Sorry, Daryl. So, Elise, in particular, has lived in a house with, what, three other girls? Is that right? Four other girls. And we've been told that singing and dancing were a constant at the house. So tonight, the girls from the house have taken their show on the road, and they're going to do a little number here for us, so please welcome the house singing. Oh, and may I say, I'm sorry, why you come up? The members of the singers, we have Anna Wendy, Jenny Joffer, Leah Hofer, Taylor Walter, and Sarah McPhillips.
Blaze. of light in every word. It doesn't matter what you heard. The holy or the broken. Hallelujah. 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 Best, it wasn't much. I couldn't feel, so I tried to touch. I told the truth, I didn't come to fool ya. And even though it all went wrong, I stand before the Lord of song with nothing on my tongue but hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
What a night. My words were going to be very brief up until this morning when we received a 3:30 in the morning wake-up call that accidentally happened from the hotel. So I had a little time to think. Quite a bit of time. First, we are so grateful for the family and friends and all the relatives. We know so many people have traveled so far that you've come tonight and shared this time with us. It's been a wonderful day. It's been a wonderful night. And you shared the lives of Matthew and Elise. 20 years ago, my sister Cindy said to us that, she said, Paul and I are already praying for our spouses, the children of our spouses. And Matthew, you probably were only a couple of years old at that time. And we started praying for Matthew's spouse. And we started praying that your parents would be Christians, that they would be protecting you and raising you the way Jesus would want you to be raised. And he blessed us with you. And he blessed us with the Bausma family. And we're so fortunate. 35 years ago, so this is not going to be real short, 35 years ago I was attending high school and I went to asked a young lady out on a date and we went to Star Wars Empire Strikes Back. And after the movie I asked her how she liked it and she didn't like it. We didn't go out on a second date. But the next weekend, I asked another lady, young lady out. And Anne said yes, and we went to the movie, and I asked her how she liked it. And she liked Star Wars. We've been married now. It's going to be 31 years next week. You came home and you told us you were dating a You told us that you actually kissed her at a basketball game, was it? And
on a kiss cam.
On a kiss cam. And that's where her mom and dad got to see the young man that was dating their daughter. I never met him on a kiss cam. And then he told me she loves Star Wars. And I thought to myself, you marry that lady. Matthew Leach, you are beginning a new exciting chapter in your life. You know you have family and friends and relatives that just love you. We're so proud of you both. We're so excited for you both. Continue to follow God. Be patient with each other and know that you are right. Congratulations.
Now we're going to hear from Elisa's, my mom and dad, Elisa's mom and dad, or my dad, Steve.
Well, you took your eyes to Star Wars, I shouldn't mind the Godfather, so you
I've been there too.
A few more years older. And that's all. But anyway, we pretty much covered everything there. We're very thankful for everybody that's come over tonight and took the time to celebrate the service. You know, it's a busy time and this kind of thing. And it's quite an honor for us to see all the folks to come to something to celebrate, something that's as important as marriage. So we want to wish you both the very best, Matt and Elise. And your future looks really good and very bright. God be with you and Godspeed, and he watches over you, and your future looks well. We thank everybody for coming and for tonight. Thank you very much for being here.
Finally, it's time to hear from the bride and the groom.
Before they do that, I want to make one just quick enough that there was a watch. Mm-hmm. Somebody's missing a watch, it was dropped by a vending machine, so it's going to be up here at the piano. All right, well, I want to start off by just thanking all of you for coming out here today and just sharing this day with us. It means so much to have so much family and friends and to see people that I haven't seen in a long time and the people that I haven't met before. It's just a great day and a lot of faces. And I'm really glad you're all here to share with us. My first met Elise, I knew that I wanted to have her as a part of my life, but I didn't think of that as, you know, what's the romantic thought. It was just kind of, I just want her to be by my side. I want to be friends with her or whatever, you know, I just wanted her around. I thought she was an awesome girl, and I just knew I wanted her there. And it didn't take too long before we started hanging out and realizing that it was more than just friendship. Found that she's a beautiful girl and really well raised, and she's just a smart and caring individual, and I'm just so blessed to get to spend the rest of my life with her. I want to thank Steve and Julie for all you've done, and I'm so excited to join your family, and thank you for raising such a wonderful woman, and for letting me marry her.
Again, thank you all so much for coming. It's so nice to see everybody's faces again and to be all together. It's something else when you have like everybody you care about in one room. It's a cool feeling, like it's really awesome. So I just want to thank you each for coming and for just being a great and fun and important part in my life and in Matt's life. So thank you so much for that and taking the time to care. And thank you for taking the time to just be you. And I also want to thank Brett and Ann, who did just a marvelous job just being so awesome to work with and just being fun to talk to and run ideas past. And you guys have put in so much work as well. And we had an excellent rehearsal dinner last night. It was amazing. So thank you very much for that. And also thank you to my mom and dad for obvious reasons. But thank you so much. It's so beautiful. And
thank you for always being there. But I'm not gonna cry, it's cool. It's cool. But I also want to thank you too, Matt, for being patient with me. It's a good thing you're getting a cognitive neuroscience PhD, because you'll have to figure me out, so. But thank you, Brett and Anne, for raising such awesome kids, and especially this one right here, and raising just the awesomest guy that I have ever met. And I couldn't be more blessed to be with anyone else in the world. It's just awesome. So thank you for you as well. And thank you all for all of you. And as the night goes on, I just want to invite you to come up and say hi, and to meet new people, to meet old friends again, old faces, new faces, and to also join us out on the dance floor if you see fit. So that would be awesome. I love each and every one of you. I'm so happy that you're here. And thank you for an awesome day.
One more thing, there's a ton of work that went into this whole wedding, this whole day, and I just want to thank everybody for, everyone that had a role. There's a ton of people doing just all sorts of stuff, so thank you guys for everything.
It was so nice to have you all involved, honestly. Thank you, everybody, from sweeping to delivering cake for the cousins to like being ushers. Thank you just so much for everybody wanting to be involved and being involved, so thank you so much.
Dan had a white poster board and created this. That's amazing. You need to give him a round of applause.
After all those toasts and comments, anything I say is anti-Matthew. I just want to say the least, and Matthew, thank you for letting me share a part today in this school way. And it's an honor to be here for this. I appreciate it.
And that brings us to the end of our program. But at least before we, before I get done, Aaron and I decided that we thought we should give a toast to you, so I'm going to give it instead. So Aaron got to do Oli, so.
He's Oli?
What?
What? I never knew that.
Spoiler!
Sorry. Just for Aaron. All right, well, we do want you to remember today and what a special moment it has been for all of us to be here, and what a special moment it is for the both of you. So right now, I would like Elise for you to place your left hand palm down on the table, and Matt, I would like you to place your right hand palm down on top of hers. And Matt, this is for you. This is a very, very special moment, and really enjoy it. Because this is the last moment that you are ever going to have the upper hand.
Well said.
As it should be.
No, this is to you, the happy couple. Thank you so much for being with us, and we would like to invite Reverend Alan Sager over to give a blessing for the couple.
Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for this gathering. Thank you for a time of fellowship and sharing, for a time of enjoying food and other people. Thank you for your love and the love you give to Matthew and Elise. Thank you for this happy event. We thank you, Lord, and ask your blessing. The blessing of your spirit as we celebrate. The blessing of your love for Elise and Matthew. The blessing of your love for all gathered here. Grant, we pray, your gifts of love, your traveling mercies for all who are here. Grant, we pray, your spirit of love in Elise and Matthew's lives for all the years to come. In the name of Christ Jesus, we thank you for the promise you are and will always be with us. In his name, amen.
Now it's time for the dance. Get your dancing shoes on and stay. Even if you're not in the mood to kick up your heels just yet, please stay and visit and get to know new people or visit with old friends. Thank you so much for coming.
Make it a long one. It's a slow zoom. Oh, that's so nice of you guys.
guys to vote for the other person. Who's the better musician?
Ooh.
Oh, there we go. Melissa's a close second, huh? All right. All right. Who likes USD?
Ooh.
Good. Excellent. Great answer. All right. Who is always right?
There you go, Matthew. Right. Good job.
All right, who's more stubborn? Well, you both think highly of them yourselves. Who spends more time on Facebook? All right, who is messier? Who's the best driver? Who has the best driving record? Who's been caught? Okay. How about who? Who wears the pants in the family, in the relationship? All right. That's good. Who dresses the other person?
Matt, figure it out. Come on.
All right. How about who's in control of the TV remote? All right, good. And who do you love more than anyone else in the entire world? All right, good job. Get those chairs out of there. I'll see if my computer...
Where it began, I can't begin to know. But then I know it's growing strong. Wasn't the spring, and spring became summer.